I think the thing about cancer is that you hear about other people having cancer, you're aware of it, but you never really expect it to affect you. I had it back in 2007, and it just literally shocked me to the core. Breast cancer, grade 3, stage 3 I think it was, and I went through a year and a half of treatment where nobody could tell me if I was going to be okay or not. But I used the services of High back in 2007, and I remember feeling so relieved to have somewhere to go. I felt it was like family. Everybody had so much empathy, was so supportive and sympathetic, and it made such a difference to my life knowing that I could come here. Over the years, you kind of learn to live with the fact you've had it, and you've got over it and you're doing okay. And then it hits you again, but this time it hit my darling late husband. So he had major surgery in April 2022, which was supposed to remove it all and hopefully cure it, but it had spread to other parts of his body. And I knew straight away what that meant. My husband didn't. He didn't realise that that meant palliative care. Even after that, he still was living in denial for quite a long time and didn't believe that he wasn't going to survive it. And I just spiralled at that point. In those early days, I did contact High because I was really struggling with it. And I remember being met and greeted by Alicia, who was just so incredibly warm. She had so much empathy and kindness, and she was so supportive. And I sat in the room with her probably for about an hour, just chatting. And I was probably crying most of the time. I've had counselling. The counsellor I had was one-on-one to start with. That was with Laura, who was also absolutely brilliant. And I remember having one counselling session with her online while I was at the hospice right at the end. And that was really difficult. And I think she even said to me, you know, you don't have to have it if you don't want to. And I thought, no, I just need to. I need to offload to somebody, a professional, because there were so many things that I couldn't say to like my friends and family. It was just too difficult for me. And I didn't want to see their reaction to my pain. And so having Laura there was just made such a difference. I did everything I possibly could to make sure that I knew what was happening and when it was happening so that I could be with him right at the end and he wasn't on his own. And actually at the end, it was very, very special. I was with his sister. We were at the hospice. It was the middle of the night. We played a bit of music to him. And then right at the end, we said the Shema as he took his last breath. And then he just stopped breathing. So when I came back to High on this occasion, I've joined the bereavement group. It's an incredibly supportive group, and we all share, we get on well. The lady who oversees the group, Tal, she's also got the most incredible amount of empathy. She's fantastic. She's always checking in with us to make sure we're okay. I would say to anybody to absolutely get in touch. Where else is there, you know, where there's a facility like this? They just provide all different types of support. And you feel like they're family. You just don't feel on your own there. You just never know when you're going to need to use these services. And I think that most people are going to be affected, unfortunately, by cancer in their lives. And I think everybody needs to be aware of High as a charity and definitely continue the ongoing support and support them if you're not already supporting them.